Hello, good morning to Mr. Faiz. My name is Lim Jia Chi from BPH Cohort 4. Today I'm going to talk about mortality and morbidity of dengue in Malaysia. Now I'm going to talk about dengue introduction. Dengue is the mosquito-borne viral disease in terms of public health issue with high morbidity and high mortality. It affects tropical and subtropical region all around the world, especially in urban areas. Later I will explain why. The etiology of dengue virus is spread to people through the bite of the infected Aedes species. Aedes is a mosquito. Okay. This Aedes species actually has two different types, Aedes aegypti or Aedes albopictus. The spectrum of disease manifestation is wide, ranging from asymptomatic, that's no symptom, mild infection, dengue hemorrhagic fever to a severe dengue shock syndrome. There are at least five major factors that influence the transmission of dengue disease. The dengue virus actually consists of four different types: dengue virus 1, dengue virus 2, dengue virus 3, and dengue virus 4. And dengue virus can be monitored by dengue virus surveillance system. The next one is the human. The next one is the environmental conditions such as cleanliness. The fourth one is the vector and its behavior. The fifth one is climate change. In Malaysia, normally our dengue peak season is in the late monsoon seasons. The image on the right side is the infographic about the sign and symptom of dengue fever: diarrhea, vomit, muscles pain, stomach ache, and high fever as well. Okay, now let us move on to epidemiology. According to CDC, there are actually up to 400 million of people get infected with dengue each year. Approximately 100 million of people get sick from infections and 22,000 died from this severe dengue in worldwide. Malaysia's first dengue outbreak is on 19 and 2 in Penang. It's actually passed on from Singapore to Penang. Dengue has become a notifiable infection by 1973. Since then, the major outbreak occur almost every 8 years because this is a cyclical pattern. Dengue impacted economical and disease burden in Southeast Asia with an estimated annual average of 214,000 disability adjusted life years loss and an overall of average annual economical burden of US$950 million. Okay, let's talk about the distribution of dengue worldwide. This map is actually obtained from World Health Organization 2016 to show the average of number of reported dengue cases from the year of 2010 until 2016. Dengue is common in more than 100 countries all around the world. The areas covers the most is Central America, South America, African, Asian and Oceania. About 3.6 billion people actually living in the subtropical and tropical regions are at risk of infected by dengue. Pandemics occur annually in the Asia, approximately 70%. Okay, let us talk about the morbidity. Estimation of 7% to 9% of the population were infected by dengue each year between the year of 2001 until 2013. The dengue incident in Malaysia continued to increase from 32 cases per 100,000 population to 361 cases per 100,000 of population in the year of 2000 and 2014 respectively. This is like an 11-fold of increment. As you can see, the graph on my right side is actually obtained from CPG. It's talking about the case fatality rate and the incident rate for the year 2000 until 2014. There is the increment of at least 11-fold from the year 2000 until 2014. According to a journal article, the prevalence rate were available up to 2008 only. And this journal article is actually obtained from 2016 and 2018 respectively. The prevalence rate was split into rural areas 43% and also urban prevalence 54%. The age, gender, and ethnicity-related morbidity. The dengue incident rate is higher in the age of 15 and above, which means this is adults. In Southeast Asia, pediatric patients of 2 years old until 15 years old are found to have more severe dengue syndrome, such as dengue hemorrhagic fever and dengue shock syndrome, due to they are more prone to hypovolemic shock compared to adults. From a review article of dengue in 2013 to 2014, there were only slight difference of 2.4% in gender distribution across the age group for dengue cases. For female, it's 45 to 55 and 59 years old has a higher incident rate compared to other ages, whereas the incident peak for male is at a younger age, which is 30 to 44 years old. And also, there were no difference in ethnicity. Okay, for the graph on our right side is the causes of dengue death among children, adults, and elderly in 2013 and 2014. This is actually similar and obtained from this review article. As you can see, patients that less than 15 years old has slightly higher of dengue shock syndrome compared to others, and also the severe bleeding also will be slightly higher compared to the rest of the age. Whereas for the severe organ involvement, will be the age more than 60 years old. Okay, for the dengue hotspot in Malaysia, Selangor is actually the red zone, as you can see. It has 34.5%. The next one is following by Johor, 15.2%, and also followed by Perak, 8.1%. About 40% of the dengue patients actually stay at the dengue hotspot. CPG of the dengue state that most cases are in urban areas because of high density population and rapid development. This will favor the dengue transmission. This is the latest Malaysia dengue in 2020 data. This latest data is actually obtained from National Crisis Preparedness and Response Center, CPRC, from the 1st of January until 22nd of May in 2020. There are a total of 38,080 confirmed cases so far. According to World Health Organization in Malaysia, the cumulative number of reported cases from 29 December 2019 to 18 April 2020 was actually 37,701 cases. A 9% of decrement was actually detected when using the data compared to the same period last year. Okay, this slide is about mortality. The main causes contribute to the dengue mortality is the dengue shock syndrome, we also know call it as DSS, followed by severe organ dysfunction and severe bleeding. Dengue mortality increased over the years. However, the case mortality ratio remained the same between 0.16% to 0.3% over the past decade. The mortality rate in 2014 is 0.2%, which has been reduced 0.4% compared to 0.6% in the year of 2000. Most of the dengue death has been observed to be higher at the age of 15 and above, that's mean adult also. Until 22nd of May 2020, the cumulative dengue death is 63 cases so far, slightly lower than the reported during the same period in year 2019. The next point is there was no significant differences in the causes of death across different age groups. Approximately 50% of the mortality rate were contributed by combinational causes and 16.6% died of dengue shock syndrome complicated with both severe bleeding and severe organ involvement. Untreated severe dengue fever may have a mortality rate of 10 to 20%. Appropriate supportive care reduces the mortality rate to roughly 1%. Dengue death was observed more frequently among patients who had sick for medical care after 4th or 5th day of fever. Okay, we have came to conclusion. Dengue death occurs primarily in adults patients. Adults patient means it's more than 15 years old, but more severe among children because they are more prone to hypovolemic shock and dengue shock syndrome compared to the graph before. Dengue shock syndrome was the leading cause of death because it will be involved in severe bleeding and also organ failure. That's all for me. Thank you.